friends don't do this, it's normally done by my colleagues. But just to say, the main reason why we had this meeting was in order for colleagues in civil society and colleagues in the media to sort of begin to plan around elections in three phases. The first being the pre-election phase, the actual election phase, and the post-election phase. And these phases are very, very important because we are already, in any event, in the pre-election phase. That's why you guys do not know much about PVI and so on and so on. But it's already on the roll. So we hope that works, and we hope that will work. We also hope that you keep in mind that freedom of expression is not solely for the media, it's for everyone. And that access to information is not solely for civil society, again, it's for everyone. And in having such a holistic view and understanding of the tools rolling in the next elections, we'll do our utmost best in difficult circumstances, yes, with limited funding if you are in civil society, and if you're a freelance journalist with no pay. But we're going to try. That's Evo's hope. And that is what we're looking forward to. That we're not going to make the mistakes we made in 2013 or 2008, if any mistakes were made. And that if we were successful in the last election, we'll continue to be successful. In fact, even more successful in the next one, in allowing people greater access to information as well as greater freedom of expression. But having said that, I would like to begin by thanking you for coming. Some of you came at very short notice. We apologize for that, as Kennedy indicated in the morning. But we are grateful that you could find time from your busy schedules, both if you are in civil society as well as a freelance journalist. We would also like to thank those, especially those that came from outside Harare. We know that these days with issues of road accidents and the like, sometimes traveling can be a scary business. And we are happy that you arrived safe, and we pray and hope that you will travel safely back home, whether by road or by air. And I'm assuming no one came by sea. We would also like to thank our excellent facilitator, Temi. Again, we also asked her to come here short notice, and she said, okay, I like you, so I'll come there. We would like to thank you very much for helping us today, and we hope some of the colleagues here, as well as you, will continue to ask you for your help and to provide it. I'd probably like to ask you to give a round of applause. We'd like to thank our fast track rapporteur. I call him Comrade Tamuka, for doing an excellent job, and we look forward to the report that you're going to produce. We would also like to thank our cameraman, these colleagues who have been taking snaps and filming some of us, both in the front as well as in the groups, as well as when you're waiting for tea, and probably asking me a couple of questions in the process, as led by Comrade Kumplan. Thank you very much for the sterling work, and we hope the video is good, both for social media as well as for our own records. We would like to thank our Twitterers. I saw a number of tweets during the course of the day. We don't know how many followers we have, or what number you are on the list that was shown by Chris. But if you tweeted, thank you very much. You've helped not only Evos have a greater social media impact, but also yourselves, because Evos, that's quite following globally. We'd also like to thank our panelists, the panelists that were up here. Those that are still with us now, thank you very much. Those that have left to see the video, that we thank them, and for the insightful information, sharing of ideas, and the insightful linking of learning. We'd also like to thank those that questioned, and also thank those that agreed to be the first, how do you say, the presenters from the group discussions. Thank you very much. It's not so easy to remember what 15, 20 people said in 30 minutes and then put it all together and be coherent, especially the young comrade who had a lot of energy. We'd like to thank the hotel staff, though they might not hear us, for serving us well. I think lunch was okay, and I don't think we need to raise. And then finally, penultimate, I'd like to thank a person who you haven't seen too much, but she's outside. Her name is Makatendeka. She was basically in charge of the administrative side of this meeting. She's an intern, a graduate intern at UBOS, and we appreciate her work. Masimba, who has left for another meeting, our communications guy, Kennedy, who was here. But last but not least, we'd like to thank the Embassy of the Kingdom of the Netherlands for providing the funding to make this meeting possible. Thank you very much. If you have any administrative issues, please see Makatendeka outside. And then I think our facilitator has one more announcement to make. Well, I can make it. We have a form that basically asks you what do you think of this meeting in about 5 or 7 questions. Please fill it in, it doesn't take too long. Don't be nasty, but be honest and be fair. And then in terms of after this meeting, there should be some refreshments and snacks served in about 30 minutes. I think it's in the room next door, but if I find out I'm incorrect, I'll whisper it by your tables as you're feeling the same. Thank you very much. Please travel safe and thank you for coming.
For these and other stories, visit our website www.263chat.com. Follow us on Twitter @263chat and like our Facebook page, 263chat.